features to facilitate that is to provide a platform to manage listings, catalog, logistics, analytics, BI, data portability. This is a very essential element of building multi-channel customer experience. Typically, also working with the warehouse management systems that are based on an historical perspective of everything offline, no system, or everything is a heavy cost of integration or a small change will cost you a bomb. That approach doesn't really work very easily if you want to build something leveraging on existing infrastructure to integrate multiple channels and build a great digital customer experience. So much more open loop systems are needed. Essentially, what we're looking here is that working with the platform and integrated selling networks, which are much more an internet service model and integrated selling logistics network instead of a very standalone AWS experience. That was the only slide I had to do this, and that was my last slide. So, as I said earlier, in Shanto, we help sellers and distributors to connect their inventory from warehouses, from 3PL companies to multiple channels, and we help 3PL companies, post offices, to transform their infrastructure into omnichannel logistics. Thank you. Stay back here.
Thank you, Vaibhav. Yeah, can I please invite all of you all back on stage for the felicitation? Thank you, Abhijit. Yeah. Mukund? Aditya? Yes, definitely. Anand? Mukesh? I'm sure the audience has many questions in mind. These dignitaries have probably perplexed you all. There's so much that has been discussed over the last 40 minutes. Questions, please. Questions, anybody? Yeah. Amit, thank you. Saving grace. Yeah, can we have a mic? One second.
This is Amit from Rockland. So I have a question which is for both of you, and the statement you made is there are hardly companies are profiting, right, in this channel. My question is, are we running behind blinded that someday this will become profitable and we are pouring in money? I know Flipkart has got some more money, but on another side in Delhi, Snapdeal has completely crashed, right? So that also comes to the capability of the people and the environment. What is it that is making those few omni-channel or multi-channel, whatever you may call it, profitable, really profitable? Is it only capability? Is it only IT? Do we know where we are heading in terms of the future of this e-channel, or is it just another bubble?
Hello.
So I'll take a first shot at it. One of the reasons why omnichannel even started was, and it started in the US, it was the fear of Amazon. Amazon was growing bigger and stronger, and the brick and mortar retailers were afraid that their lunches and dinners are going to be eaten by Amazon. So they said, okay, let's create an environment where customers will have the feel of E while they're dealing with the brick and mortars. And yes, initially the first few years, people kind of jumped into the race, blindfolded. But over the last 10 years, there has been a lot of learnings that have come through. And is it a bubble? I don't think so. But does it require a focused strategy to make it profitable? Absolutely yes. And again, I'm not saying IT systems are the only way to go to do omnichannel. It is the value proposition that you want to provide to your customers that is going to decide the level of omni-channel that you want to be at. So, fast fashion, omni-channel makes a lot of sense. You have a customer walking in who loves a trouser, but the matching top is not available in the size that the customer wants. Are you able to identify the nearest store that has the inventory? Can you ship it to the customer's address in the next 24 hours? That is saving a sale. With the concept of identifying inventory and getting it to the customer is infinite time, but those are the kind of challenges that, as long as you know exactly what you're doing, it can be profitable. If you try and do everything at the same time, you're not going to get anywhere. That is the import.
Thank you, Anand. Any other questions? Okay. Can I request Afreen Patel from Rolling, the Director of Marketing and Sales, a lady with a lot of experience, started her career with AFL in 1987, worked up the ranks, a decade with AFL as I remember, moved on to PAX, BDP after that, and is now with Wise Rolling. But Afreen, may I please request you to present the mementos? Anand. Second to Mukesh. Yeah. Abhijit. And we have Vaibhav. Professor Mukund. And Aditya. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you for such a wonderful session. I'm sure a lot of people from the audience would like to take offline questions with you all. Thank you so much. Thank you, Afreen.